Hey guys, Justin here. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video. So I have been doing videos with this TV. This is a Samsung QN90B. I have the 50-inch version. And previously I have shown you the unboxing, the operating system, some of the newer features, functions, how it works. And I also did some gaming with the Xbox Series X. I shared my gaming settings. And I also did a side-by-side comparison with the C1 Oled that I have here. So if you're interested in those videos, go check out my previous videos and subscribe to the channel if you haven't. Now this time I wanted to connect my PC and use this as a PC monitor. I have an RTX 3070, which is not like the best gaming PC out there, but it is very, very capable. And it also supports HDMI 2.1, which means that you can kind of play at 4K 120Hz. But this TV also supports 144Hz of refresh rate, and it doesn't have a DisplayPort. So I was wondering, is it possible that I can go up to 144Hz with HDMI? Let's find out how it works and also what you need to do in order to achieve that 144Hz if I'm doing things right. So welcome to the channel, I'm Joster, and let's do this. Okay, so right after you connect your HDMI cable, the TV will detect and change the input to PC, which is fine because you are connecting a PC. Now the problem with this is that you only have a few options, and then you don't have that game bar option at the bottom. See, I'm pressing the button play on the controller and it doesn't open the game bar. What you want to do is you want to go to settings right here, and then let me show you. If you're using just PC mode, you only have two options, which is entertainment and graphic. That's it. I turn on HDR from my Windows PC display option, but you only have a couple options. So you want to go and turn on game mode. Let's go into connection. Let's go into game mode settings, and I want to turn this on. There you go. Now I have the game bar at the bottom, and I have the picture mode settings, which I'm using standard right now, but you also have the same options as if you're using a console. Also, you can change the screen ratio. I am using 21:9. No, this is the one that I selected, but normally I'm using 16:9. If I want to change to 21:9, I have to change the resolution as well. I normally don't do that. I don't really feel the need to do that. But if you want to, you also have the option of 32:9. Over here, we have the speakers, the sound, help guide, game settings. At the bottom, I don't know if you guys can see, but it says FPS 144Hz, HDR is on, and also VRR is on, which those are options that you can do on your PC. Okay, so I open up NVIDIA control panel, and the first thing I wanted to do is just change the resolution. Normally, this will be right here selected on top. It says Ultra HD, and this says recommended 3840, 2160, 4K or 2K, but you will be limited to 60Hz. I've seen this before, but if you want to use 144Hz, you can have to go right here down where it says PC. You have 3840, 2160 options, and then you will be able to see refresh rate, 144Hz, 120Hz, or even 100Hz. Depending what you want, but obviously I'm going to go for the max power, right? You notice if I select this, this thing's changed to 60Hz, and that's it. You can go all the way down to 23Hz, but why would you want to do that? So make sure you use PC 2160, 144Hz of refresh rate. Let's go and set up G-Sync, and I do have enabled G-Sync. Even though this TV doesn't officially support G-Sync, but it does have FreeSync Premium, but it does support G-Sync as well. You can enable it here and just apply it, and boom, you have G-Sync also available on this TV. And just to show that everything is working fine, you can press this button right here on the controller, the center button, and you have that window in information, 3840, 2160, VRR, 144Hz of refresh rate, HDR is activated. I mean, you have everything working with this monitor and this PC. So let's try some gaming. Let's do this. All right, guys, so first I'm going to start playing Shadow Warrior 2, which is a very colorful game. I really like it. It came out a few years ago, and it was one of the first games on PC that came out with HDR. So this is an old school game. If we press this button here, we have the information. If we turn it, you can see the refresh rate jumps from 143 to, like, it drops sometimes, but it is very stable. You guys notice that? So yeah, let's go and check out this game. It's really smooth. I really like it. I don't know what, oh my goodness, there's bunnies. The bunny lord. Yeah, I got him. Oh my god. So I have to kill these bunnies. They turn into these big old monsters, I guess. But yeah, this game, it's very, very cool. Super colorful, and I think HDR still looks excellent. So one thing I did notice is that HDR look kind of washed out, the colors. So what did you have to do? And I think this goes for every different game. I mean, every game is different. Now over here, we get access to gamma, and I think gamma makes a huge difference. For example, I have it 0.8. If I increase it to, for example, 1, you guys will notice that the picture gets a little too bright. I think it's just like colors look a little washed out. Even though on the camera it may look good, but I think it looks a little washed out, and you want to just be sure that you get the right settings, because previously I had it too high and it just looked really bad, too bright, and I lost a lot of details. So you can see the colors a little bit more saturated, more vibrant, and it still looks fantastic. Now let's go over here, play a little bit. Oh my god. Another option that you have here in this game is you can play around with the HDR brightness. So right now I have it at 1.1. You can increase it all the way to 1.45 or 55. It depends what you want to do. But what I like about this is, like, just the whole game, even colors, they get brighter, and it's very, very colorful. I like this a lot. Alright guys, so now I'm playing Warzone right here, and it runs very, very smooth. I really like it. Let me check out the resolution. Okay, so right now it has VRR is on, and the frequency is around 70 hertz, 73 71 73. So it's not, you know, it's not 144 hertz, not 120 hertz, but it is very, very smooth, and I think it looks great. Look at this details. And one thing I did notice is that the picture gets very, very bright, and there's nothing much I can do here. Let's go into the settings. Let's go into the graphics right here. So if I go down to the gamma, it is locked for some reason. I cannot make any difference. It says sRGB usually for monitor and BT1886 for TV, but right now it is locked. It's not actually letting me make any changes. HDR here is enabled. HDR brightness, it's set. Let me see if I can lower this. Might make any difference. Actually, you know what? This card, I don't wanna. Yeah, I think it's too bright. So let me go into the settings from the TV, and I'm going to let you know what I'm using right now. Let's go. Brightness is all the way to 100 or 50%, which is 100%. I don't know why Samsung, this is kind of confusing. Contrast is 50. Sharpness, I have it down to 5. Colors is 30. Right here, local dimming is on high. Contrast enhancer is on low. Maybe this will make any difference. Yeah, but no, I don't like it. I don't like it. I actually, you know what? Actually, high looks way more colorful. But I think I still like low. I think high is just too bright. Let's just leave it in low. The color tone is in warm 1. See, warm 2 is too yellowish. Standard actually doesn't look bad, but I still prefer warm 1. I don't know, I like that. In gamma, it's in BT2084, and you cannot change it. It won't allow you to change this. You see, this function isn't available. So what I did is I reduced the gamma to -3, because if you leave it in the middle, it gets too bright, and then colors look really washed out. You don't want to do that. So I lowered it down to -3, and I think they look the picture looks solid, looks much, much better. Shadow detail, I don't think makes any difference, but as a matter of fact, it does make a difference. Yes, let's turn it all the way down to -5. It does make a difference in the picture. And color space, I'm using native, which it looks much, much better. If I do auto, oh man, colors get so dull. I do not like this. Native looks so much colorful. This is just depends on, you know, everyone has a different taste. I like to see my video games with a more colorful, more impactful. I like to have colors a little bit more saturated, but not over saturated. That's what I like. So yeah, that's how this TV works as a PC monitor. I think it looks so nice. Look at this. I see things popping up. Yeah, it looks sharp, looks beautiful. I like this. All right guys, so in conclusion, should you buy this TV to use it as a PC monitor? Absolutely, it works fantastic, looks great, colors look amazing, it's very bright, resolution looks sharp, even with small little details or small letters, everything looks sharp and clear. And also performance, it's really, really good. Also keep in mind that you need to have a capable PC. I have an RTX 3070 and also that supports HDMI 2.1. I guess my only complaint will be the size. I mean, this is a 50 inch. There's also a 43 inch size version available. But I still think 43 inch is too big. I mean, the biggest size I will go to use it as a monitor, it will be 32 inch, which is what I have here. I have two 32 inch monitors. And the reason is because I'm sitting about 2 feet away and I don't have more space, or my desk is not even big enough to use this TV as a monitor. But if you have the space and if you don't mind sitting further away from the TV slash monitor, I think that's totally fine. It is totally capable. Another positive I like is that between this model and the 42 inch OLED, I will definitely choose this one because I don't have to worry about screen burn or permanent screen damage, especially if you're going to use it as a PC monitor, which there's always going to be a static image right there, and their chances of getting permanent screen burn are so much higher. And with this TV, you don't even have to worry about it. So that's it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for stopping by. And as always, please consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't, and also leave a like to the video if you enjoyed this kind of content. I'm Joester, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Joester out!